You guys want to see something cool? I have had this idea in my head for 3 Halloweens now. Spooky season, my favorite time of year. And it always makes me take those ghoulish vibes onto the tabletop. The idea is a shambling horde. I love a good zombie. Max Brooks, George Romero, COD zombies, Plants vs. Zombies. Zombies are great, but what really makes them a threat is zombies en masse. You can't fight them, you can only hope to get away from them. And this year, I finally decided to do something about it. I got some zombies. A lot of zombies. 40 zombies. 80 zombies. 120 zombies. 160 zombies. 200 zombies. And I'm gonna build and paint them all. Don't try this at home, kids. I am a professional. The models for this seasonal fiesta were provided by Mantic, makers of great games like Kings of War, Firefight, and my favorite, Dead Zone. I told them about this little project and they were just as excited as I was to see it come together. Halloween is full of spooks, and none spookier than zombies. I have never painted a zombie before, and before we leave a comment, no, poxwalkers don't count. I am very excited to get started, and soon enough, I will have my very own shambling horde ready to spooky up my war games. I got to know my zombies. 3 zombies per sprue. This is the only sprue layout. These are modular zombies with all sorts of different heads and arms, so I got to know the singular sprue really well. This is a lot of plastic. This is by far the largest project I have taken on. Way bigger than Indomitus, bigger even than Dominion, way bigger than a silly old Imperial Knight. This is gonna be something. And I wanna get it done in a reasonable amount of time, but what is a reasonable amount of time? Because if each zombie only takes me 15 minutes, that still means I'm gonna be sitting here for over 33 hours. And if I can get that down to 5 minutes a zombie, that still means I'm gonna be here for 16 hours, a little more than 16 hours, so better get to it. Although I am a painter at heart, I do like assembling models, especially plastic models. It's a little therapeutic, just sitting and accomplishing a task. It doesn't take much thought, and it lets me zone out and focus on what spooky movies I wanna rewatch this Halloween season. Although some of that fun is lost when you're building mountains and mountains of zombies, with the sprues piling up to the ceiling. The heads of these zombies are really fun, especially this head that is the spitting image of Bruce Willis. Oh my goodness, now I know exactly how Tyranid players feel. This is a lot of bits. It's taken me about 3 hours to clip them all off the sprue, so hopefully it'll only take about 3 more hours to get them all built. It's possible, right?
Cutting out was the easy part. Every piece needed some connection trimming and sanding. And because these zombies are poseable, I used some plastic glue to stick them together exactly how I wanted them. Look at these little fellas. 3 down, 197 to go.
When working on a big old project like this, motivation can become an issue. A lot of the steps take a very long time, are very boring and tedious. I could sand every pair of legs, every torso, every set of arms, every head, but instead I'm gonna be working in squads of 10. That way, I'm gonna get some positive reinforcement by actually finishing things every 15 minutes or so, instead of having to wait hours and hours and hours until the very end to get any satisfaction.
Although I was all in on getting my zombie horde up and running before Halloween, I don't know if I recommend tackling huge projects all in one go. It's a big commitment, it takes a lot out of you, and hobbies should be fun and stress-free. There were a few times during assembly where all I wanted to do was stop, play Minecraft, and eat Doritos. But I do love a challenge from time to time, so zombies. As the horde neared completion, my wrists were hurting, my eyes were getting tired, I was starting to feel like a zombie.
Two hundred zombies all built put together. Took about 10 hours, but now I get to paint. Well, actually I don't get to paint because I have to put them on bases. And I bought 225mm bases for this project. These are model railroad train accessory bases. And how are these for model railroads? What grandpa is putting his conductors and passengers on 25mm wargaming bases? Whatever. I really hope they counted before they filled up these boxes, otherwise I'm gonna be in trouble.
Seeing 200 bases in front of me was another cold dose of reality on just how much 200 models are. But I got to work. These zombies are meant to live on square bases for Kings of War, and their feet are attached to pucks of plastic, which is a little frustrating, but I get it. That puck is gonna give these zombies a rock solid connection to the base, and without it, it would be almost impossible to glue their tiny little feet down with any real strength. I sound like a broken record at this point, but this took a little while.
Well, kudos to Eva Model, Model Railroad Accessories, because they actually gave me 208 bases. Now to give the ground a little bit of texture.
To make a seamless transition between the puck and the floor of the base, I took some Milliput, rolled out a snake, and squished it down in the gap. I always do this to make my minis perfect, but after fixing about 40 zombies this way...
No, you know what? Life is too short, I'm about 40 zombies deep, I am not Milliputting 200 zombies. I'm just gonna throw on the sand and hope for the best.
I poured out wood glue onto some garbage and got to work saturating the base. I sprinkled on some pebbles, gave each base a healthy scoop of medium grain sand, and then finished it off with some fine grain sand. And you know what? It looks fine.
200 zombies.
I don't like building models anymore. Time for painting.
Alright, it's time to paint, which is the best part. It's when I can finally make these zombies come to life. Well, I guess back to life.
Double stick tape is the oldest trick in the book. I stuck it on some paint stir sticks and turned these 200 zombies into 5 zombies on a stick. This is gonna make it easier to spray paint them and save me time.
Now that I have my 200 zombies turned into 5 zombie sticks, patent pending, I'm gonna be doing as much painting as I possibly can. I'm gonna be doing a mottled zenithal highlight.
I started out spraying them all purple. I didn't worry about coverage or spray angles, I just squirted the paint all over, and I did the step again and again and again, using greens, browns, blue, tan, and once my zombies were colorful, I gave them even more colors with some transparent blue, green, yellow, and magenta inks.
And you know what else has lots of colors? That's right, our Patreon. Over there, we have brand new miniatures every month. This October, we had the Duchess of Paradise and Carnival Terrain. When you sign up, there's a welcome pack that includes Dawn of War-inspired terrain, all hosted by Comics, Games, and Things. There's also Patreon-exclusive videos and weekly Discord hangouts. We also have merch, link in the description. 20 hours of building zombies, but only 3 hours in on painting, and they are looking slick. George Romero would be proud.
I finally broke out the wet palette. It's time to do some actual painting. The first step, a dry brushing. I alternated between a cold gray and a light pink that I mixed up. I tore the zombies off their sticks and gave each one a little wipey. Building takes time, but painting is quick. Each zombie got about 5 seconds of dry brush time.
I now have a massive pile of zombies. And really, I could be done right now. I could have just army painted or speed painted them green and been done, but I have just a few more little steps and one experiment I would like to run before these guys are perfect.
These zombies have some clothes, and I want to pick out all of their little loincloths with some speed paint. Speed paint because it's transparent, so the colors underneath will show through, and because I have so many different colors. Some got green undies, some got brown undies, and some got slightly different color brown undies. I was going for variety.
This is the last loincloth on the last zombie, and so now I would love to apply a wash to really bring out all of the details, but I don't think I want to do an acrylic wash. Acrylic washes that you get a really nice recessed shade, but you also get a darkening of everything. And these zombies are already pretty dark, so I don't want to make them any darker. And so I think an oil wash is going to let me have those dark recesses while keeping the raised areas nice and light. I'm not very good at oils, but what better way to try it out than on 200 zombies?
I got out my small collection of oil paints and set up a palette. I made a dark green wash, a magenta wash, and a brown wash that I never actually used, but seemed like a good idea at the time. One trick with oils I've learned is to wipe off as much paint as possible on a paper towel before cleaning my brush in the mineral spirits. That way I don't have to constantly refresh my wash cup and waste it. I started out by washing the models with the green, then dabbing it with a paper towel to pull off the excess. Then I went in with that magenta wash and put this on their mouths and fingertips. This is where the magic of oils came in handy. I took a clean brush and pushed around the magenta, and this blended the color into the model very smoothly and quickly. I find oils challenging, because they act very different to acrylics. Where acrylic paint dries in a few seconds, oil stays wet for hours. And also, I am very messy. Which is no big deal with acrylics, but with oils, I had to actually stop and clean my hands from time to time so I didn't accidentally get paint where I didn't want it.
The oils worked out. They actually worked out really nicely. I would love to try more oils on some other projects, but it did take a fair bit of time. Now, the only thing left on these guys is the base, and the zombies ended up fairly dark and realistic as far as zombies can go. So that makes me think, if I want some good contrast, I'm thinking maybe something very unrealistic for the bases.
I bought this color on a whim at my friendly local game store because I thought it looked pretty. Jade green, a very different tone to the green-brown disgusting zombies. I made up a slurry of this paint and water and began slapping it on. This thin paint mixture will take advantage of all the steps I did before it. All those colors will show through just a little bit and make the bases more believable as ground and not just flat blue color.
200 bases done, and my zombies are essentially finished. The only thing left to do is to paint the rib of the base black, which usually takes about 30 seconds, because I'm painting 3 to 10 guys. But on 200 models, it's going to be a bit of a slog.
I painted a base rim black, and then another one, and then another one, and another one, and another one. But knowing the end was in sight gave me the strength to push through and get those base rims painted, because soon enough, I won't be painting, I'll be gaming.
Oh, that was a lot of building and painting. All told, it was probably about 25 hours of work, which comes out to just about 7.5 minutes a zombie. And this is a first for me, I have no idea what the finished product looks like. Usually when I paint a model, I am staring at that sucker and I learn every millimeter, every speck of detail, but this project was different. It was just go, 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 paint, paint, paint. I didn't get to know a single model. I would say I'm acquainted with the Horde, but when I put down my paintbrush, I had no idea what any single zombie actually looked like, which is kind of cool. I get to reintroduce myself to my own army.
Like this guy holding up a severed head for the perfect selfie, or this guy waving his hands in the air like he just don't care.
This is what 200 zombies look like on the gaming table.
200 zombies ready to wreak havoc on my Space Marines, Nyx Orcs, or anyone else I can rope into playing a zombie-style narrative game with me. Which I imagine will be a lot of people, because look how awesome this is. Sure, one box would realistically be plenty of zombies. 40 is already a nice horde, but to truly get how epic and unwinnable a zombie outbreak is, I needed the numbers. Zombies fit right into any war game. I'm gonna use these in Kill Team, Dead Zone, Age of Sigmar, Warhammer 40k, heck, even Star Wars Legion. Star Wars is no stranger to zombies, like the book Death Troopers or the Geonosis arc from Clone Wars. They may not have weapons or tactics or skills, but what they do have is purpose. They need to eat, and if they pick you as their meal, they will never stop until you are sitting in their useless belly. The only way to prevent this is to run away or a well-placed headshot.
I painted some zombies. I've wanted to do this project for eons of battle, and now it is finally complete. Now that the ultimate batch painting endeavor is over, I am very excited to get back to some proper painting. Happy Halloween!